Michael, I said to you before the game, it's been a season where you've had a few firsts for the club, you know, winning away at Plymouth in a long time, a first win for the club at Charlton as well today after a good performance.
Yeah, I mean, it was a strange game, wasn't it? I thought when it was 11v11, felt really, really comfortable, thought we were playing well, thought we were causing problems. Obviously, going front, and then obviously with the sending off, as what can happen a lot of times, a little bit of a lull in the game, but we still were sort of creating opportunities and a little bit sloppy in the final third, certainly in their box. And then obviously, you know, goes without saying, like the messages you tell your players at half time, don't give the referee an opportunity to square it up. And, you know, unfortunately, that's what we did. And whether it was a sending off or not, it doesn't really matter because we're given the opportunity to make that decision and we shouldn't have. So Morgan will learn from that. And then obviously, it's like scoring a goal. You're the home team, you're behind, you've levelled it up in terms of personnel. And it gave them a little bit of a lift, and the crowd got behind them and put us under a bit of pressure. Once we got the second goal, obviously you're a little bit calmer, but yeah, it's like anything. Once you get that second one, all of a sudden you start dropping a little bit deeper, and we did that and invited too many crosses into the box. But listen, we've seen it out. It's been strange all season in terms of so many things go against us. So today, you know, if we've got the rubber green and one or two things, why shouldn't we? Because, like I say, it's been a tough old season.
Leslie Morgan had a curious game in some ways. I'm sure the Charlton manager will be frustrated with their defending for the goal, but from your point of view, the goal?
With Morgan's?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, listen, it was a decent finish in the end. He had two or three opportunities to let fly, and he chose not to, and then, you know, those ones are obviously difficult to... I don't know if he went through someone's legs, but... I only have to go back to last Saturday. You know, we're in a game against Shrewsbury. It looks 0-0 for all the money in the world, and then all of a sudden, you know, it's gone through Regan's legs and it's crept in the corner. So he probably needed the goal at the time because he was a bit loose with his possession. He was giving the ball away a little bit. But yeah, obviously, you know, he's hurting a little bit now, obviously, because I'm not sure if it's his first sending off, but obviously he's not the type to... certainly get sent off for any high challenges.
Yeah, you didn't seem to protest at us watching on the sidelines about the decision. From what you said, he obviously gave the referee a decision, didn't he? But from our point of view, it looked like he was off the floor with the challenge, and we know what these are these days.
Well, yeah, I mean, listen, if he would have kissed him, he probably would have got sent off. That's the situation it is, isn't it? You know, like, obviously, you're a intimidating place. You know, player gets sent off, whether they like it or not. It's two, you know, it's two yellow cards, and yeah, it was just a little bit silly to give him the opportunity to make that decision. But he'll learn from that. But, you know, them type of things. He's a very young lad, still very inexperienced in terms of the amount of game time that he's had as a player. And you know, listen, we've been fortunate enough to not like let it hurt us. You know, we've got him, we've won the game, and like you say, we've had good spells this year. We've played well at times, and not got the result go our way. And today, fortunately, we have
high quality goal from Anthony.
Yeah, I expected it. I think when he gets in those positions there, because he was so close to the goal as well. You know, I certainly expected to see the net rustle a little bit. But I think it's one of them where he went through a spell of sort of trying it too much. You know, and he got found out a little bit. But now, obviously, he's mixed his game up a little bit. He certainly was putting Jamie in a lot more than, you know, previous games when maybe Cohen was there, etc. So delighted for Scholes. I thought he played well. Forget his goal, but in terms of general play, he was much sharper than he had been in his previous performances. Clearly, he's had to have this injection in his knee, which he had before last week's game. It's settled down properly now. He's had a 4 weeks training, and his performance shown that.
We had Brooke as man of the match. They had a very difficult first half, very dangerous player who was up against. Second half, thought he was exceptional. And sometimes people say how great a player is when they're at home as a fullback, and it's a different game, isn't it? But to come away to, like a place you said, that intimidates, a real shine of a sign of what Brooke has to offer as a career going forward.
Yeah, I mean, I think what he did was he showed a bit of personality, and he pushed Blackett Taylor back towards his own goal a few times. Whereas, you know, because the out-and-out pace that Blackett Taylor's got, that doesn't happen too often. But Brooke's quick, and, you know, he's strong as well. He's got a good core. He's, he can handle himself, and he's shown real composure at times today, certainly in around the touchline when challenges were flying in. He was, you know, he had the confidence to nutmeg people a couple of times to get away and get himself out of trouble. Shown real maturity in his performance, and I was delighted for it.
So just finally from me, Michael, a great away day for the 1,100 Lincoln City fans. Obviously, it's not been the season everyone's would have wanted, but it's been a great day. And we should also mention, obviously, your club captain coming back and putting in a captain's performance as well. But all in all, a great day.
It was good. Yeah, it was great. Fans enjoyed themselves, I'm sure. Those who stay down tonight will probably enjoy themselves. Those who go back to Lincoln will enjoy themselves on the train. And yeah, I think, obviously, Brid's coming back in. It just gives us that extra security. You can tell we've missed him for the majority of the season. You know, we're definitely a different team with him in the team, and I think that was proven today.